blessing. Happy Pentecost.
Happy Pentecost.
Thank you. So, it is Pentecost, as you, I don't know why you noticed, we have a lot of extra stuff. I do have a special children's message planned for today. I'm very excited about it. And it's so special that I moved it right after the Thanksgiving for baptism. Also, you may notice we have some banners up here. I want to thank Diane Whisker for creating those. Thank you, Diane. Yay. Also, I want to thank everyone who helped out with our Mother's Day high tea bruncheon. It was wonderful, so huge thank you to Anne Marie and the Fellowship Committee for their hard work on planning and making that event happen. Speaking of fellowship, if you would like to attend the Sod Poodles game, which is always a good time, please see Anne Marie. Today is the last day to sign up. So I received an email from Pastor Charles Meyer this week. He sends his greetings. He serves as the Synod statistician. So if you make a boo-boo on your report, he will let you know about it. So, and then of course, I'm going to say, you know what I'm going to say. This is my last Sunday before the big trip to Germany. Yay! I am very excited. but I want to assure you that while I am in Germany, you all will be in good hands. Pastor Arlen Lloyd, who is our dean of our conference, he serves at Oslo Lutheran Church in Rolgruber. He will be handling pastoral care emergencies while I am gone. There is more information on that in your bulletin, so please review that. And then we have Jerry Moeller leading worship on May 26th. Pastor Mike Holmes will be visiting. He will preach and preside on June 2nd. And then Wanda Garcia will lead worship on June 9th. So I'm very thankful and grateful to them for helping out while I am in Germany. Also, not only is it Pentecost today, it is MES Sunday, which means it is Mission Endowment Fund. We do this every year. I have some information if you'd like to learn more about the Mission Endowment Fund through the MTNL Senate. It is a wonderful thing that we have. We have an endowment, right? It's a wonderful thing to have, and it's nice to also have an endowment in our Senate. And basically what happens is churches can apply for grants every year to either start a new ministry or maybe enhance an existing ministry. So it is a wonderful gift. I have a special sermon that I'm going to preach today. I'll talk more about that once we get to the sermon. If you would like to learn more about the Mission Endowment Fund, I have these. If you would like one, just let me know. And also, our very own Linda Allen serves on the board. And I know she would love to have conversation with you all about that. Actually, Oslo Lutheran Church applied for a grant, and they received it. So very exciting. So, I think the church in Wilson has also applied for a grant. But that was a couple years ago, and they received it. So it's a wonderful, helpful tool so that we can continue to do ministry. And another thing is the money stays in the Synod. So it is all right here in our Synod. So if you have any questions, I can talk to you about that. All right, so now let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship as we listen to the prelude in silent meditation.
Thank you.
you are able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the wellspring of grace, our Easter and our joy. Amen.
Amen.
Look, here is water.
Here is the water of life. Hallelujah.
Immersed in the promises of baptism, let us give thanks for what God has done for us. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your voice thundered over the deep, and water became the essence of life. Adam and Eve beheld Eden's verdant rivers. The ark carried your creation through the flood into a new day. Miriam led the dancing as your people passed through the sea into freedom of women. In a desert pool, the Ethiopian official entered your boundless baptismal life. Look, here is water.
Here is the water of life. Hallelujah.
At the river, your beloved son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you opened the floodgates of your reconciled love, freeing us to live as Easter people. We rejoice with glad hearts, giving all honor and praise to you, through the risen Christ, our source of living water, and the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Look, here is water.
Here is our water of life. Hallelujah.
You may be seated. At this time, I'd like to ask the children to come forward for the children's message. I need your help. Come on down. You coming, Grace? Well, welcome, everybody. So, I need your help with something today. So, today's Pentecost. And something really amazing happened on the first Pentecost. Well, not really the first, but... So, the Holy Spirit came down, and it was like these tongues of fire were on people's heads. And it was kind of, they didn't get burned, though. They were fine. But it gave them the ability to speak in and to understand different languages. Cool is that? I really wish the Spirit would come so when I go to Germany, I understand what they're talking about. But anyway, so because it's a very festive day, see, we've got red on, we've got the banners. So I want to talk a little bit about the colors. So I designed the banners, but Diane made them because, well, you know, that's not my forte. So what I have done is I have made these little flags. So the red is for fire, and the white is the dove. In the Bible, the Holy Spirit is sometimes described as fire or as a dove. So I want you want to hold up for me?
I have white and red on my shirt.
Yes, you did. Yeah, a lot of people wore red today, adding to the festive nature of today. All right, here's a flag for you.
Yeah, I have white and red on.
Yes, you do. And then I've got a flag for, I should have enough. There they are. And let's go to the bottom. Okay. Here you go. Woo! Flag. Put it for you. Oh, that one really good. There you go. Would you like a flag? There you go. And I even have flags for the adults. Any volunteers? Here you go. legs. Okay, there you go. Anybody else? Oh, Lori. Okay, awesome. There you go. Any other takers? I got Betty. Oh, Diane. Here. Do you want one, Jess? Okay. It might be kind of long. I hope I have one. Here, I'll give you a little one. Okay, there you go.
This holy house where all who worship you center our lives in the water and the word, that you nourish our souls with your body and blood. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear ye.
Today's first lesson is from Acts 2. When the day of Pentecost had come, the apostles were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues, as of fire, appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages, as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native tongue of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language, Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt, and parts of Bithynia belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages, we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them. Men in Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you. Now listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. The last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heaven above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire, smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today's psalm is Psalm 104. I'll read responsively. O Lord, how manifold are your works. In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures.
Yonder is the sea, great and wide, creeping things in innumerable order, living things so small on the earth.
There go the ships and the leviathan that you formed to sport in it.
The kings all look to you, to give them your food in due season.
When you give to them, they gather it up. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things.
When you hide your face, they are dismayed. When you take away your breath, they die and you turn to their dust.
When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the ground.
May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works.
Who looks on the earth and it trembles, who touches the mountains as the end they smoke.
I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praise to my God while I have need.
May my meditation be pleasing to him, for I rejoice in the Lord.
Let sinners be consumed from the earth, and let the wicked be no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Praise the Lord.
The second reading is from Romans 8. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, or who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is in the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
According to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, when the Advocate comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who comes from the Father, he will testify on my behalf. You also are to testify because you have been with me from the beginning. I did not say these things to you from the beginning because I was with you. But now I am going to him who sent me. Yet none of you asks me, where are you going? But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. it is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will prove the world wrong about sin and righteousness and judgment. About sin, because they do not believe in me. About righteousness, because I am going to the Father, and you will see me no longer. About judgment, because the ruler of this world has been condemned. I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all truth. For he will not speak on his own, but will speak whatever he hears. And he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, because he will take what is mine, and I declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine. For this reason I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
You may be seated. So I'm doing something a little bit different today. So as I mentioned, it's MEF Sunday, and I am preaching a sermon that I did not write. I know, it's shocking. The sermon that I'm preaching today was written by the Reverend Donna M. Wright. She wrote it specifically for today, and she is a board member of MEF, so this is going to be interesting. Actually, I've read it. It's really good. And the sermon the title is The Spirit Sings. Love, comfort, and power to you from our God, made known through God's Holy Spirit. Amen. Don't tell me you can't sing. You can talk. You can sing. Maybe not well, but you can sing. Singing is just the same as speaking. The internet program called Auto-Tune takes what people have said and makes it sound like a song. The programmers of Auto-Tune have taken advantage of their understanding that singing is just sustained speaking. Speaking that goes on longer than you might think speaking should go on. Come to think of it, God's Spirit goes on longer than you would think it would go on. The Spirit goes unnoticed most of the time. In both Hebrew and Greek, the word for spirit also means breath and wind. It is easy to take the wind for granted, unless you are in the middle of an ocean on a sailboat with either too much wind or not at all. Okay, I'm going to insert something here. Unless you live here in Amarillo. And sometimes it is so windy you think you're going to blow away. Okay, I get that in there. Okay, back to Pastor Donna. It is easy to take breath for granted, unless you suffer from allergies or pulmonary disease. In the same way, it can be easy to take God's Spirit for granted. We revel in the wondrous creation of God the Father. We study and meditate on the words and acts of Jesus, even closing most prayers with "In Jesus' name." Every Sunday, at least one of our readings is about Jesus. However, God's Spirit gets little more than passing emphasis, even on Pentecost Sunday, the day on which we Christians celebrate the coming of God's Holy Spirit. But God's Spirit goes on longer than you think it would. It is surprising, like a gust of wind or a sudden calm. God's Spirit can sound like a glorious chant or a lovely symphony. God's Spirit can sound like a country and western twang or the most rhythmic rap. Sometimes we take God's Spirit for granted. But whenever we do, we make a mistake. Like the sailor who takes the wind for granted, or the person who has breathing problems without their oxygen tank. God's Spirit sustains us like oxygen to the hospital patient, or like the wind those waiting for the weather to change. God's Spirit sustains us, keeps us alive, keeps us enjoying life. God's Spirit lifts us up. Like music lifts our spirits, so God's Spirit lifts us. Sustaining is what God's Spirit is about. God's Spirit that animated the apostles on the first Christian Pentecost continues to sustain and animate Christians today. Christians are still telling of God's deeds of power. Christians are still gathering and praying and worshiping, sometimes in secret, as not every country is as open to worship of different religions as ours is, because it is against the law to worship publicly. Our ELCA delegation and their friends in the Orthodox Church in Turkey worship secretly in a hotel room. But God's Spirit sustained them. God's Spirit is also powerful and surprising. There are a lot of weird things that God's Spirit helps people to do. On the day of Pentecost, 50 days after Jesus' resurrection, God's Spirit helped Peter and the other apostles speak in numerous languages. They spoke fluently. More importantly, they spoke powerfully of the great things that God has done, of how God wanted us to be closer, and how God became human and suffered, as every human suffers, out of love for us, and how God continues to love us by giving God's own Spirit. While Jesus' followers were speaking powerfully, others assumed they were drunk. That too is the power of God's Spirit, to be taken the wrong way. The ways of God's Spirit is often misinterpreted. It is true in many of the stories found in the Bible. It is true in our stories too. Powerful and surprising. Almost 30 years ago, a small group of pastors and laypersons were inspired by the same Holy Spirit that came upon the first disciples of Pentecost. They started a fund that would give money to churches to do extra ministry in their communities. That was the birth of the Northern Texas, Northern Louisiana Synod's Mission Endowment Fund. From a start of $25,000, the Mission Endowment Fund has grown to $1.7 million. That fund has given away over $1 million while still maintaining that $1.7 million as a perpetual endowment, so that the singing of our Mission Endowment Fund goes on longer than you think it could go on. God's spirited disciples in our Synod still see the needs of their communities and apply for grants to do special ministries that they couldn't otherwise afford. This will continue well into the future, and all of us play a part in this working of the Spirit of God. When Jesus told his followers that he would ask God to send them an advocate, a Spirit of truth, he reminded them that he does not give to them as the world gives. Jesus gives to us the church, the experiences we need for what is next. Even the experience we call troubles, God uses to bring us closer to God and to each other. Jesus gives us opportunities to give, such as to the Mission Endowment Fund, and opportunities to receive from that fund also. From God we receive the Spirit of God that reminds us that we are God's children. God's Spirit helps us to remember that we are adopted by God. He is close to us, not at a formal arm's length, but so close that hugging is easy. From God the Father and Jesus the Son, we receive the Spirit to sustain us. God's Spirit was poured out on the whole church, not just Peter, although didn't he give a powerful sermon? God's Spirit was poured out on the whole church, which then spoke and sang and gave away God's love, and has not stopped doing so. Amen.
us confess our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love has triumphed over fear, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need of good news. We pray for the Church Universal, for its ministries, and for the spread of the gospel. Shower your spirit upon Sunday school students, confirmands, and the newly baptized. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
For the earth, our precious home, we give thanks for the diversity of plant and animal life on our planet. Empower us by your spirit to be wise and faithful stewards of all you have made. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
For the nations and those who govern, give those in authority understanding hearts that they work together to bring justice and peace on earth. Grant all who vote in elections wisdom and discernment. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
For those in need around the world, for victims of crimes, for victims of sexual abuse and exploitation, and those who are incarcerated, for all who suffer in any way, today, we especially pray for Audrey, family of Michelle Miller, and those on our prayers. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
For this congregation and its ministries, for those who plan and lead worship, for acolytes and communion servers, for readers and tech ministers, for all who prepare and clean our worship space, may our worship be pleasing in your sight. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
God, hear us now as we pray either silently or aloud for others on our hearts and minds. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We remember the faithful departed. Give us thankful hearts for those who have gone before us in the faith. The last day, breathe new life into our dry bones, that we might feast forever with all the saints in light. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, most merciful God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abiding love, through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Oh,
be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Risen One, you call us to believe and bear fruit. May the gifts that we offer here be signs of your abiding love. Form us to be your witnesses in the world through Jesus Christ, our true vine.
Amen.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Amen.
Send us forth from this banquet to proclaim your goodness and share the abundant mercy of Jesus, our Redeemer and Friend.
Amen.
Hallelujah! Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah!
The God of resurrection power, the Christ of unending joy, and the Spirit of Easter hope bless you now and always. Amen.
Amen.
Our sending hymn is Every Time I Feel the Spirit, which is printed in your bulletin.
Thank you.